is not in our office.
Please repeat after me. I, Michael L. Parson.
I, Michael L. Parson.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will support.
I will support.
The Constitution of the United States.
The Constitution of the United States.
And the Constitution of the State of Missouri.
And the Constitution of the State of Missouri.
And I will faithfully demean myself.
I will faithfully demean myself.
In the office of.
The office of.
Governor of the State of Missouri.
Governor, State of Missouri.
So help me God.
So help me God. First of all, just let me say thank you for everybody that's here today. I want to thank a lot of my family and friends that are here from back home, many people across the state that I've known in my career to be here today. Public service is a privilege, and it is truly an honor to serve as Missouri's 57th governor. My pledge to all Missourians to work hard each and every day to bring honor, integrity, transparency to the governor's office. We have an opportunity beginning today to have a fresh start in state government. I believe now is the time for Missouri to come together, to work together, and to help one another. I will always be ready and willing to listen to ideas on how state government can better position itself to serve our families and our communities. I am optimistic about the future of our great state, and I'm looking forward to the work ahead. God bless you, God bless the great state of Missouri, and God bless the United States of America.
Fill seats on the state school board, the housing development commission.
We are very well aware of the school board, the state school board. We aim to get that board up and running as soon as we can.
Governor, do you believe you have the legal authority to appoint a replacement as lieutenant governor, or do you think the legislature needs to clarify that law before you can do so?
We are looking into that right now. I do believe that there is some validity in appointing the lieutenant governor of the state of Missouri, as with most other offices. It needs to be cleared up. We would have liked to have got that done this year in the legislative process, but we're going to look into that further, and I think it is important for the state of Missouri to have a lieutenant governor, especially at a time like this, to be able to help with the governor's office and to be able to work together for this betterment of the state of Missouri. So I think that's an important position, and I think it will become a much more important position. And needless to say, I think the lieutenant governor is a very important role in the state of Missouri.
Governor, how much healing do you believe?
Jason Rosenbaum, how much healing do you believe will have to happen in Missouri?
How much healing, sir?
All right, excuse me, Jason Rosenbaum.
Your predecessor had an unprecedented opportunity to enact policy change as a Republican governor with a very Republican legislature. Many people felt that he squandered that chance by not having a good relationship with people. How are you going to grasp that opportunity, and how are you going to avoid the pitfalls of your predecessor?
You know, I think anytime you're in a leadership position, it's about relationships. That's what makes true leaders in this state and this country. And I think building relationships, which I've got some history here in this building with the legislatures, both in the House and the Senate, on both sides of the aisle. But I think we need to build those relationships. There's many, many common grounds for the state of Missouri, such as infrastructure, such as workforce development. There's many things like that we come together. And my purpose for being the governor will be to try to bring people together, to try to move the state of Missouri forward for what's best for the state.